Hey, what's up guys? So in today's video, I'm actually gonna show you guys how to make this full-size spare tire carrier for your car. It's gonna be universal if you have a hitch, so keep that in mind. And also, I'm gonna show you guys how I can do it for under 200 bucks in materials at least. And I'm gonna try to do it in a 2 or 3 part series. So in this particular part, I'm actually gonna show you guys how I did the prototype and show you guys how I tackled the hardest part, which is the anti-wobble system. And for those who don't know me, my name is Ratha Sochenda. I'm a designer and maker, and I actually like to solve problems using CAD and metal fabrication. And I'll show you guys how I create this from start to finish. So after I got my 35s mounted, the fifth wheel no longer fit the stock location that's underneath the car. So for me at least, it really wasn't a big deal not having a full-size spare tire with me at all times. I mean, it's nice to have, but you know, if I have a flat, let's say within a 5 mile radius of my house, I can always call my wife or a friend to just load up the fifth spare tire for me. But because camping season's coming up, these trips are normally 3 to 5 hour drives. So, you know, if I get a flat, it'd be probably a good idea to have a full size spare in that scenario. So the issue I was facing was, you know, where would I put this full size 35 inch tire? I thought about putting it in the trunk space of the 4Runner, but you know, when we go camping, I got my kids' stuff, I got my wife's stuff, and all the camping gear, and the trunk space is usually packed. So that wasn't gonna work. And I thought about actually throwing this guy on top of the roof rack, but lifting a 35 inch tire onto the roof rack, it was a pain in the butt. This thing's super heavy, and having to bring it back down, that's a backbreaker. So I was like, yeah, that's not gonna work. I then searched a few options on how others were storing theirs, and I really started like the Hitch Tire Swingout option. One, because it was simple to install, and when you're done with it, you can actually put it back like a bike rack. You can unhitch it from your hitch and store it away, so it's not permanently mounted on it. And second, I think it's a good alternative to a full rear bumper if you don't want anything permanent. And third, it's universal as long as you have a hitch receiver to mount it up to. And lastly, I think it looks pretty cool. I think it gives you that overlanding look, or that off-road look, I guess. And I guess for me, at least, that was kind of the look I was aiming for. Because I like to design and make things, I set out to build my own.
The goal set for this project was that it had to be universal or be slightly modified to fit any car with a hitch receiver. Because this was going into the hitch, I wanted no play or wobble. And I budgeted the materials to be all under $200.
To start off the design, I first had to figure out how to solve the hardest component of the build, which was the anti-wobble system. This isn't a really new concept, there's just not enough information out there on it. So my goal was to figure that portion out.
I was a little surprised because I had learned about this concept firsthand when I assembled my daughter's bike. It was how the handlebars attached to the head tube of the bike. Here's a simulation of how this anti-wobble system will work inside of your hitch receiver. The wedge slides up to create tension as you tighten the bolt. Now that we have that out of the way, next was to get 3 important measurements off the car. 1, how far the hinge will be from the hitch. 2, height of the swing arm from the hitch. And 3, how tall the tire will need to be from the swing arm. To dial it in, I inserted an image of the rear and scaled it. Then overlaid the model with 2x4s, as I would be using wood first to make a rough mockup. This will help me address any clearance issues I may run into and adjust any parameters in the CAD model before I build it out of metal.
All right, so before we put this wood swing out prototype all together, I kind of wanted to give you guys a quick overview on exactly what I did to each piece. So we'll start out with the 2 main pieces, which is the swing out arms. You can see I actually did a notch cutout, and the reason why I did that was I wanted to fit this piece here, which is, I guess you could say, this is my 3x5 flange, and the raised portion is supposed to kind of represent the hinge bolt, and that's my reason for that. So pretty much you'll have your flange piece that goes just like that, and you'll have another one that goes on the bottom. And then next, you'll have your tire post. And that's pretty much gonna go something like that. It goes up like that. And then you have the actual arm, I guess you can call it the post arm, that actually holds the actual tire. And you can see there's a slight angle so that the tire falls parallel to that lift gate. And I think it looks better that way versus just the tire being perpendicular. So that's my reason for that angle there. And then, let's put those away. And then next you have the, I guess you can call this my anti-wobble part. This is the piece that actually goes inside the hitch of your car. I actually cut this out perfect to match the inside, I guess you call it the inside dimension of the hitch itself. And that's pretty much gonna go somewhere on the bottom. And this will all make sense once I put it all together, and I'll explain it further once it's on the car. So pretty much the goal of making a wood swing out is pretty much to check for clearance, obviously. And it's just cheaper to do with wood versus steel. So for the three main dimensions that are crucial for clearance is the distance from the hitch, the far left of the hitch to the hinge, and the distance from the bottom of the hitch to the top of the swing out, and then the top of the swing out to the actual top where the tire mount is gonna go. Those three main dimensions are super critical. Let's start out with one, the hinge location. So where the swing out is gonna pivot. And the reason why that is important is, let's say I have it installed on the car now and I open my lift gate, clears the swing out here, and it clears, you know, my giant 35, which is great. Now imagine if I took that hinge and I moved it too far to the left, let's say I moved it here, this whole piece is here. And when I open it, let's say in the 90 position, and I open up my lift gate, there's a high chance it might hit my tire. So I picked this area here based off the far right line that you see off the lift gate, so that when the lift gate opens up, the hinge is, I guess, right at it, right in the center of it, or to the right of it to clear it. And this will make more sense once it's on the car. And so the reason why this second critical dimension is important, the height of the, where the swing out is in relation to the tire mount, is that I wanna make sure that it's high enough so that when I grab my latch, which will be here, the tire doesn't get in my way. It's easily accessible. I don't have to like reach under or it's blocking it. So that's one reason why. And the second reason is I'm gonna try to make it as, I don't wanna make it super tall because I don't want this tire hanging out really high in the air. If I can have it closer to the fixed point, you know, that just reduces the amount of flex that this piece will flex in this direction. And the third dimension that is important is kind of like the first one is this height here. You know, if I can get this height closer down to the fixed point, less flex. Makes sense, right? And then the other reason why that's important is you don't want it too low because you want some clearance underneath, you know, if you overland, I guess. I'm gonna draw a 35 inch template, which will represent the wheel itself. I hope that all makes sense. And if it doesn't, you know, let me know what doesn't make sense in the comments and I'll try to answer to the best of my abilities. But other than that, let's go install it on the car right now and kind of see how that all works. Next, as you can see, the hinge is all the way out here. Looks like we could bring it in just a little bit more. I'm gonna trim this a little bit further because I think it sticks too far out. I want it pretty much, the hinge to be like kind of right there. Right there would probably be ideal. And I'll give that a shot real quick. All right, so the secret sauce to this anti-wobble system is pretty much, this is the piece that's gonna go inside the receiver piece. It's cut at an angle here. This is about a little over 45, and it has a fixed thread. It's welded on there. And then you have your wobble part, which slides over. And you can see, because it's cut at an angle, as you tighten this, it'll actually slide up like this. And that would actually create tension inside the receiver of your car. To complete the setup, you'll have your washer and you'll have your bolt. And as that gets tightened up, it'll rise up. And I'll quickly show you how I do that real quick with this impact. You can see it there, it actually went about up a quarter of an inch. And as far as the wiggle room, when you put this piece in, you'll have about maybe a 16th or maybe an eighth at most of wiggle room. So knowing that the system can travel up a quarter of an inch, it's gonna be more than plenty as far as keeping tension on this portion that goes inside the receiver of the car. But yeah, that's pretty much the wobble system. It's not really that complicated. There's just not a lot of information out there on it. And hopefully this clears it up for you guys. So that this makes a little bit more sense, imagine this is the receiver that's in the back of your car, right? You wanna have it installed up this way because gravity, we want this down. So right now, it goes in. You can see, there's a lot of wiggle room right now. And I wanna at least have a little bit of overhang, so I'll go past the receiver just a tad bit, and then hold it down real quick. And then I'll tighten it up next, and you'll see that it'll keep tension on this receiver. Pretty much check it out right now. There's no wiggle room, won't shake or have any slack. That's pretty much how it works. It's pretty cool. I'm glad I got this portion knocked out to begin the rest of the build. All right, so I know that was a lot to digest. We talked about the wood prototyping, and we talked about the anti-wobble system, and we still have a lot more to cover, but I'm gonna end it right here. I think I'm gonna make this whole tire carrier build a two or three part series. I'm not sure yet, just because we have a lot to cover, such as the hinge, the swing out arms, the wiring for the license plate, and possibly the rear backup camera. If you found this video helpful, make sure to smash that like button and subscribe for stuff like this. Other than that, I'll see you guys in the next episode. Later.